Coast and around the world. It's time to praise the Lord. Praise the Lord covers the major Christian events in America and across the world, from the heart of Europe. The tip of Africa.
Praise the Lord.
From the centers of Asia. To Central and South America.
Europe. Largest prayer and praise gathering. Joining us from the International Production Center in Irving, Texas are Grammy-winning, platinum-selling gospel duo, Mary Mary, President and CEO of Manigon Enterprises, John Gray, urban missionary, hip-hop artist, and minister, T.R.U.T.H, EMI gospel recording artist, Myron Butler, and Levi. Ready to take your calls. Prayer partners from around America. Contemporary gospel artist, producer, and worship leader, Kurt Franklin!
Dallas, Fort Worth! How you doing? If you're doing good, let me see a big Kool-Aid smile. Let me see you smile. Let me see your teeth. Even if they ain't your teeth, let me see them. You paid for them. How y'all doing? Hug three people, tell them, I love you, boo. Hug them and tell them, I love you, boo. Say, I love you, boo. A grown man feel uncomfortable hugging another grown man, talking about, I love you, boo. Hugging another grown man, talking about, I love you, boo. That's right, hug your homeboy, talking about, I love you, boo. Love you, boo. If you're glad for another day of grace and mercy, high five three people and tell them, I'm glad for another day of grace and mercy. Come on. And if you're grateful for forgiveness, make noise one time in here. Sit down. Woo! 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 We had to do it again. How many of you guys came the last time we did it? Back then? Incredible. Incredible. So we had to do it again. We ran out of time that night. So this is the part two of that night. It was wonderful. I want to thank TBN for inviting me back out again. Let's give TBN a big hand. Big hand. All right. What'd you say? Okay. So we're going to be hearing a lot of that tonight. We're going to hear from these people tonight. Trust me, they came and they've been practicing that all day. Very excited about your scream. That's a good Jesus scream. Very inspirational scream. Like that. Keep that up for Christ. For those of you who may not even know who I am, I'm Fort Worth's own Kirk Franklin, country boy, church boy. Fort Worth, Texas. Collard greens, black eyed peas. Ranch-style beans, fried chicken, chitterlings, naked bones, hogamoles, country boy, I thank God for my mama, the woman that raised me and taught me about Jesus, Gertrude. Someday we'll sing together when I get there. I thank God for her. Thank God for all the mistakes and struggles. I was raised in Fort Worth, fell in Fort Worth, made my mistakes in Fort Worth, and I'm so glad that God, just like the great chef that he is, making the meal, knows what type of ingredients to put in it to make the special preparation for our lives. He just don't put just the sweet stuff, but he also mixes it with a little bit of sour because he knows exactly how much to put in there to make it work out. For Romans 8:28, all things working together for the good. Just all the witnesses in here that are stronger now because you didn't have it easy. Make some noise right now. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. That's right. So listen, you know, we're going to have a great time tonight. I'm so excited right now. Now, you know that I don't try to get all too, too traditional and too deep, you know. We're going to laugh. We're going to laugh. We're going to have some fun. We're going to worship. We're going to dance. We're going to cry. We're going to sing. We're going to get excited because for some of y'all, we already know 2006 is already starting off a little, you know. What's good about spiritual growth is the more you grow, you can kind of see the devil on the horizon. And a lot of stuff don't sneak up on you like it used to. So some of you in your spiritual preparation, you can already kind of see, you know, some of it. You're like, all right. But that's good because you know that the weapon formed won't prosper. So it's like, so for those of you, we want you to come tonight and just be reminded that he who began a good work in you, he shall complete that thing. So, who is that? Oh, excuse me, ladies and gentlemen. Hello. Say, girl. Do I know you? Have I not just spent the last 10 years with you? Ladies and gentlemen, can you help me show some love? My baby's mama's in the audience. Tammy Franklin, stand up, girl. Stand up, baby. Come here. Oh, Lord.
I ain't no baby's mama. Give me my title. I work hard for wife. Wife.
You know, baby, you ain't got to do me like that on TV, baby. You ain't got to do me like that on TV, baby. We're going to talk about this later.
Wife.
My wife and I just celebrated 10 years. Show us some love. So we got a great night. We're celebrating family. We're celebrating all the heroes. We're celebrating everybody who sacrificed and just made it go through. Those of you that took care of people with the hurricanes here in town. Those of you that sacrificed time and money. Those of you churches that are hanging in there that have been going through the transitions. Everybody in this room that had to fight to keep your head up in 2005. We're celebrating the heroes, the people that you never read about them in the magazine. You never read about them in the newspaper. They don't have awards. They may not be driving the biggest and the hottest whip, but we know that your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. And when heaven and earth passes away, I want you to know that when he sees you, he will say, well done. So help me show some love right now for my first guest. Beautiful, talented. Like I said, it was so great the first time. We had to do it all over again. Mary, Mary! Yeah. Sit down. Hey, how you doing?
How you?
I'm good, how you?
How you doing?
I'm good, how you?
How your mama and them doing?
They doing good.
Mama and them doing good.
They doing.
These ladies look beautiful, don't they?
Thank you, Kerry.
Yeah.
You might have cleaned yourself.
Again. Well, if I could have done my jeans, y'all should have done my jeans. But listen, we got a great announcement. Huh?
Yes, we do.
We got a great announcement, and we got to let everybody know what's going on. That's why I brought you up here first, because we got to tell everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, just boys bring and girls.
We're going on tour.
Mary and Kirk Franklin.
We're going on tour. The hero tour.
We're going to celebrate the heroes everywhere.
Yeah. Right? That's right. And it starts the end of this month.
Yes,
yep. And we've been talking about it for years, and we just kind of been playing around with it, and so now we got the opportunity, and I'm excited.
I'm excited, too.
We're going out.
I'm a fan of yours. That's why I'm excited. And I get to hear your music every night.
And I'm a fan of yours.
Thank you,
very much. And so now the vision is, this is what we're doing. We're going into every city.
Yes.
And with the radio stations involved and the churches involved, what we're going to do is we're going to celebrate people in that community. For example, like when we come to Dallas, you'll be able to vote the person in your neighborhood that you know of. For example, it may be the lady who watches all the kids in the neighborhood and she don't get paid for it.
Yeah.
You know, that lady. Or the man who works on all the single mother's cars and does it at a discount. Those local neighborhood heroes, we're gonna celebrate them. They're gonna get a chance to win a new car.
They got real loud on that. Everybody go, I'm a hero, Kurt.
We're going to get, you know, they'll get like the whole VIP treatment to the concert, limousine for them and their spouse, backstage passes. They'll get a chance to win some awards. And so we're going to do that in every, now we ain't going to give a car in every city.
Amen.
Sorry.
We can't do it like Oprah.
Maybe tires. We give a tire and a hubcap. And by the time we get to the last city, it'll be a whole car.
One of them a rim, one of them a steering wheel.
But they'll get a chance to be part of this big final prize of winning these cars. And so we're going on tour. Show some love one more time. Kirk Franklin, Mary. So be looking out for that. So listen, you guys got the new album.
Yeah.
I'm loving the new album.
Thank you.
Y'all just won an American Music Award.
Ain't got all right.
y'all just won Stella Awards.
Yeah.
Huh?
It's cool to win those awards, but there's a lot of people who don't win the awards.
Yeah.
Because we were nominated for quite a few that we didn't win.
Mm-hmm.
But one thing that you have to know whether you win or you don't win,
that's right,
who you're singing about.
Amen.
What you're really, really doing it for. I can't feel like I serve a better purpose in the kingdom just because I won an award. Because there's somebody who don't even have a record deal, and you are very effective in your church, and you are drawing people to God and encouraging and uplifting. And we want those people to feel important. So, I mean, I'm not trying to downplay.
No, I think
is great.
Let me tell you something. I'm so proud that you just did that. Really, really. Because you got a lot of talented kids in this audience right now. You got a lot of talented people watching that see, they're clapping for themselves. Talented, mm-hmm. Clapping for themselves.
Yeah. Give it up for yourself.
That's right. I'm talented.
I am. Yes, I sing. I do a lot of things.
But
amen.
And a lot of times we look for validation.
Yes. Yes.
When the Father wants to be the validation that we're looking for.
Yes.
Because Christ knows that if we look outside of Him for anything else to fulfill us, we're gonna keep on looking.
Right.
Amen. And nothing else will satisfy. It's almost like every satisfaction will just be for a quick second.
Exactly. And then He only gives you what He can trust you with.
That's good.
If He knew that Mary would get out there and start wilding out and wearing all kind of crazy stuff and we wasn't talking about Jesus no more, He might yank all of that just right up from under us.
That's
Thank
good.
You for your song and your time. It's over. I can't trust you.
Right. That's right.
I would hate to hear that, you know?
That's right.
I would hate to be standing on stage and I'm singing and I know I'm not anointed and I'm just trying to move in myself and my flesh because I have a platform.
Giving folks goosebumps. But not effective in ministry.
I don't want to give goosebumps. I want people to be changed. I want to be effective. I want to win people to Christ. I want them to be real. I want them to be open and be honest about who they are and where they are. That's why I appreciate you so much, Kirk, for being honest, because you help people like me. I, Kirk and Tammy being married 10 years has helped me and my husband. We've only, what, 4 years? This is going to be 5 this year. And we watch them, on the cover of magazines and doing it big for the kingdom.
Amen.
You know what I mean? They're doing it big for the kingdom. And I just think that's beautiful. And I want us to all be that way. I want us to represent God in a way where I don't run into people on the street who go, oh, them church people ain't about nothing.
Yeah. Right, right.
I heard that so many times, right. And it breaks my heart.
Yeah. Right, right,
because
right.
Because that's us representing him bad. He's all good at all times. Amen, amen somebody.
Well, you know what you can?
You gotta represent him that way.
You know what you can do that I can't do? What y'all can do that I so can't do is y'all can sing.
Aww. You can sing. I got your record, Kirk.
Can y'all give me...
your record.
Can y'all give me a selection?
We don't give you a selection, but you're going to have to give us one before it's all over.
No. No, I ain't gonna sing.
Come on, y'all, say, Kirk, Kirk.
Hold on. No. We're gonna do some sing. Hold on. We got the singers in the back now. We ain't coming for just the, we got singers. But I want y'all to be able to sing, because I think, first of all, I think it's beautiful. It's like, now, y'all like for real sisters. Y'all not like, like sisters in Christ.
You're right.
Y'all
like, 15 years.
Right. Same sisters and same mama, same dad, and y'all singing. And so I think the people just need to know how blessed we are to have you in our lives, and how blessed we are that we're about to hear y'all sing. Show some love right now for Mary. Mary!
Well, come on, somebody up in here, and I need to break through. And you came in looking, you got me for something to happen for you. Well, I came to let you know that.
You got the victory. Don't you know you?
Mary, Mary, y'all.
Come on, come on, come on.
Now, you know I got to do this. I always got to do this. Because I know that a lot of people realize that this new gen... Okay, yeah, sit. Damn. Or if you want to dance, dance. Whatever you want to do. Whatever you want to do. Because I know that a lot of people, you know, feel that this generation, this new generation of singers, that it's all studio. Right. You know what I'm saying? A lot of people think that it's all contrived. And see, whenever I get like cold singers like y'all, I always want y'all to just break them up just a little Acapulco. Oh, because see, no, let me
Acapulco.
Tell you why. Because let me tell you why. Because ain't y'all getting tired of like buying a CD? And you buy a CD and you put it in and you like, they can't really sing. It's like, don't you remember when you could buy like an old Milton Brunson album?
Oh, yeah.
Huh? You remember that? Oh, you remember you bought like an old Winans album and it'd be like Marvin be just killing on it. Now you buy records, you get one or two good ones. It's like Jesus, if I can get three, let me get three. And so I want y'all to hear that these girls can just flat foot, just sing. Can y'all give me just a little taste? Can you give me a little taste of something?
She mentioned Milton Brunson.
Give me a little taste.
Well, I need a cup of water before I do my beat selection.
No. See, then you can't really sing.
Right.
You can't really sing. Like, if you need a mint and all that,
right,
you can't.
Right, it's the air, the light is coming.
Can somebody turn the air down? Mm-hmm.
No. Come on.
A little bit.
Okay. Come on, give me some now. We're on TV now. Come on.
Lord, I'm available to you. My will I give to you. I'll do what you say do. Use me, Lord, to show someone the way and enable me to say my story is empty.
Now, if y'all really make some noise, I think we can get him to come back and give us one more later. Can we come back? Mary, Mary, y'all. Mary, Mary. Woo! Lord. Uh-oh. What's the chant, though? What's the church chant? Lord. What? Now, you know that because we're in Dallas-Fort Worth, we know that it's singers even in this audience. Y'all realize that, right? I'm looking in the audience, and I see some of the baddest musicians, Skeet, some singers. No, I'm saying, folk don't understand. Texas? What a camera. Texas? Dallas-Fort Worth, Texas? Houston? Lubbock? Kern. As a matter of fact, there's a lady in front of me that I can see that can sing, and she don't even know I'm walking up to her. Can I give you the mic, and can you just give me just a worship? It's like, lady, please, would you, ma'am, just to show that even an audience. I didn't even know, and I want y'all to know, I didn't plant her. I didn't plant her right here. I just saw her face, and I want y'all to see. That's right, the camera's on me. I'm in the audience. I'm going to give you the mic, and I want these people to know that Dallas-Fort Worth got some of the best talent, the best gifts. Just come on.
Jesus, you're the center of my joy, and all that's good and perfect comes from you. You're the heart of my contentment, hope for all I do. Jesus, oh, you're the center of my joy, Jesus. You're the center of my joy, and all that's good and perfect comes from you. You're the heart, my contentment, hope for all I do. Jesus. Oh, Jesus, you are. You're the center of my joy. Jesus, you are. You're the center of my joy. Jesus, you are. You're the center. You're the center of my joy. Jesus, you're the center of my joy.
Wow. Everybody from the Potter's House, Joy Hill. Hallelujah. Y'all remember that song?
Yeah.
Ooh.
She did that.
Cried a lot on that song right there. Cried a lot on that song. Hallelujah. 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 So see, we're gonna have a blessed time tonight. If you really believe that, let me hear you one more time. Let me hear you.
When I lost my direction, the chin, it could be fun.
Man, I have a chin. Oh, y'all, my beautiful 16-year-old daughter is in the audience. And I want y'all to just get on camera so y'all can see how beautiful she is. Show some love, wave. That's Carrington. Oh, and next to her is, that's Kaziah Zaza. That's Zaza. Say hi, Zaza. That's the human beatbox right there. How you doing, man? I love you, man. You know, I have had an opportunity to kind of be like a father, like a brother to young men and young women in this city. And try to share my struggles and my mistakes with them, and just like Joy, I see so many talented people right here that live here that are just so full of just gift. And I wanted to bring back this young brother again because he was here the last time we were here back in November. And I didn't get a chance for you guys to really get a chance to really meet him. He just came on real quick and he sang, but a lot of times I want you guys to get a chance to know the heart of the minstrel. And so this young man has been in my life, for about the last 10 years, well, last 15 years, because we're in the DFW Mass Choir together when we both had hair. And so he went on the Morehouse and he can, he's almost like a little young genius, really, you know, his writing, you know, his scoring, you know, and I want you guys to really get a chance to know him. He's got a new project in stores and everybody watching, I really want you to get this record because not only are you supporting true talent, you're supporting a young man, married young man, who is very, very sincere about the kingdom work. And if you really want to really support somebody, then you really want to plant seeds in good soil, please. The name of the group is called Myron, Butler, and Levi, and I want you to get a chance to just meet him. Everybody show some love for my little brother, Myron Butler.
What's up?
How you doing?
What's up?
Wow. You look good, boy.
Thank you. Well, you know.
You look good.
Thank you.
I'm so proud of you, man.
Thank you.
Now, listen, last time you were here, we didn't get a chance to really find out about your vision. What's your vision? What's your heart?
My heart and my vision and my motive is to really be an example of reconciliation to the body. I think so many times we see the differences, the disagreements, the you go your way and I go my way. But we never see the coming back together. And if the love of Jesus dwells in us, then it supersedes anything in this earth, anything of this earth. And so it's really my heart and my desire to really be that example of reconciliation coming back together. You know what? I love you. And not just that superficial love, but I love you.
Yeah.
And I really mean I love you.
Yes.
And that really is my heart.
Wow.
Nothing else. You know, nothing less, nothing more.
So now how did God give you the whole vision of the Myron Butler and Levi? What did that come from? What turned that on?
It 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 was turned on a long time ago. I knew it was always something I was supposed to do. I kind of felt the call and the nudge to really, you know, have a ministry and to really walk in that ministry. But there was some nurturing that God needed to do in me, some teaching, some learning, some observing, some sowing, and some seeding into other ministries that God had to work in me. And so from early on, it was always something that I knew eventually God would bring it to pass. Mm. But in His time.
Yeah. Say that one more time.
In His time. And a lot of times, you know, people ask, you know, well, what would you say to this person? What would you say to this person that aspires to? Just really don't rush it. Don't rush it. Because God knows. God knows where you are. God knows the gifts that He's placed inside of you.
That's good.
And in time, that's He good. Will bring you before great men. He will.
That's good work. That's good work. Proud of you, boy.
Thank you.
Thank you. Now you married?
Yes, I am. My wife is here. Baby, where you at? Did she make it? Oh, she's back there.
She with the kids. Got the kids. So now, brand new artist.
Yes.
Married with kids.
Yes.
You know how I am about family.
Oh, yes.
It's like I'm the, you know, family. How do you do it? How do you keep that balance? Just as a newcomer, new family. Y'all been married how long?
3 years.
3 years, yes. New kids, you know, how do you do it? Just kind of give some encouragement or just some lessons that you're learning.
Yes.
Some mess ups that you've made.
Yeah. You know, we always hear communication, but I've learned that men and women communicate differently.
You learned that?
Yes. We communicate differently. And there's so many times when there's been a situation and my actions did one thing, but I didn't say it with my mouth. And I was, you know, I'm like, but I did this and I did that. And she's like, but you didn't say it. Can I get a witness, somebody?
Yeah.
And you know what? You know. And you know what? The joy that I find in it every day is expressing to her that I don't know everything. But I'm willing, but I want to mess up with her.
That's nice, boy. I like that. Now, see, y'all leave him alone. Jumping him. That's good.
Thank you.
So now, right before you sing, tell us about the album.
The album is Myron Butler and Levi on EMI Gospel. It was released November 8th. So if you haven't had a chance to go get it, I pray that if you go get it, I promise that it will be a blessing to you, because God wrote these songs in me over years and over lessons learned and mistakes made. And this is just kind of me chronicling the journey.
That's
and
good.
So, you know, I really pray that it blesses, you know, everyone whose ears it touches. But it is in stores now. And
he said it's in stores now.
Now.
And I love the album. It is an incredible album. Please support it. Because now you got some, now some of y'all done bought the Laffy Taffy
well,
Young Jeezy and Lil Mike and all these boys with this mess in their mouth. You know what I'm saying? Y'all stop buying all that mess up their babies and y'all buy some of this Jesus music. Y'all get some of this Jesus music. Y'all get something that's gonna feed your soul. Paul Wall ain't gonna feed your soul.
Wow.
So I love the album.
Thank you.
I love you.
Thank you.
I love Levi.
Yes.
They look good.
Yes.
They sing good.
Thank you.
They sing wonderful.
Thank you. Thank you.
So please show some love right now to Dallas's finest, Myron Butler and Levi.
Come on, put your hands together right quick. I don't see you in the back putting your hands together. Come on, put your hands together. Here we go, right here, come on. Switch! You didn't switch. Keep it going.
just simply says this. I don't even know.
One more time, Myron Butler and Levi. The album is in stores now. Set Me Free is the first single.
Yes.
Call your radio stations in the morning.
Please.
all over the country. Tell them to play this song. It's a great song. I love the song. I love the great. And you know what? As a matter of fact, we're celebrating men and women that are right from here that's got all this extremely just gifted, all this talent. You have a young lady that's a friend of yours and mine that's singing with you.
Yes.
And I think that she is the best thing since sliced bread.
Sliced bread.
And she don't know. I won't even bring her up here.
Uh-huh.
But I love her.
Yes.
And I want everybody in TV land to get a chance to meet this young lady. Because I think that very soon we're going to be hearing so much about this young lady.
Yes.
And she's served in so many ministries. And she's a writer, a singer. Show some love for Candy West.
Candy West! Come on!
Come on. She doesn't know I'm going to do this. Come on. She doesn't know I'm going to do this. Candy and I met back with God's Property, and I fell in love with her singing then. And her mama can sing.
Oh, Lord.
Her mama's name is Tommy Young West. And her mama can sing. Yes. And so she come from a whole plethora.
Uh-oh. Say it again.
Plethora. You know you get the word and you just use it wrong, you know. Feels very plethora in here, you know. But I want everybody in Dallas-Fort Worth to get a chance to also meet you too, because I believe that great, 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 great things are really going to be in your future for your gift. Now, man, you know that in God's agenda, he don't always mean millions of dollars when it's great things. It could be great things for souls and lives and hearts change. We don't put a dollar sign to God's kingdom. But I believe great things is when we can wake up and we're happy with ourselves. That's a great thing. But I know that this girl has potential to do some great things however God want to do it. And I believe in the gift. I believe in your gift. And for people that have not heard you sing, can you just give us just a little something, please? Just give us something. Come on. If it's something that you wrote, because the stuff you write is beautiful, y'all, I'm telling you, it's incredible. She's an incredible gift, y'all.
Yes.
TV land, she's an incredible gift. All right? Go ahead.
Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me. Walk with me, Lord. Walk with me. While I'm on this teacher's journey, it gets hard sometimes, but I
ladies and gentlemen,
Candy West,
you're going to be seeing a lot. I believe in it. Show this homegirl some love one more time, y'all. Marilyn Butler and Levi, y'all. Come on, one more time. They'll be back. How y'all doing up there? Hold on, let me go on this side. How y'all doing up there? Now, for everybody in the middle of the do it loudest, we're going to Dennis. How y'all doing up there? Praise God. Amen. My Uncle Denny, we're going to take... Thank y'all for coming. We're having a great time. How y'all doing down here? Okay. All right. Okay. That's enough. The TBN audience, y'all are the best audience ever. Y'all just come with Jesus. You know, you ain't got to make it happen. So we still in store for a great night. So sit back. It's just going to get gooder and gooder. This last time we were here, this young man right here, you know, we were... You know, I think that he really left an impression on our lives, and we had to bring him back. And, you know, he's a very talented young man. And I'm so impressed, and I just really believe that for a lost generation, that he is a voice that can really speak to the culture. And if you didn't get a chance to hear him last time, we brought him back because we were just so blessed by him. His name is Emmanuel Lambert, but we know him as The Truth. What it do? What it do?
What it do?
What it do? What it do, family? What it do, family? Yeah. So how you doing?
Excellent, man.
Yeah, man. The last time you were here, man, you rapped. Because you are a rapper, right?
That's what I do.
Yeah, you rhyme.
That's what I do.
That's what you do. You rhyme.
That's what I do.
Like, yeah. And so, that's what grandmama said. Oh, he raps. He raps. He's a rapper. That's what he does. But it's even deeper than that, man. It's like, I want you to know that man, just the emails and just the responses that we got just from the last time you were here was just, it was bananas. Mm. And I want you to just really get a chance to just finish what you started that day. It was incredible. Mm. We're so blessed by you. And if you don't have the boys' record, and if you're going out and if your kids want some hip-hop, and if you want something that's Christ in the culture, the album is called
The Faith.
And it's by an artist called
The Truth.
And so, That's good. You want your kids to do that about somebody that's a Christian. You want, ow!
Absolutely.
Yeah, you want that.
Yeah.
You want
yeah.
that. You want that.
Celebrate, yeah.
They ain't gonna do that over Bobby Jones. And that's okay. They not gonna do that. They ain't gonna hear Bobby Jones go, ow, Bobby Jones. They're not gonna do that. They're not gonna do that over Sherlyn Cease. Ow! They're not gonna do that. They're not gonna do that. But they'll do that over him. He cute, he light-skinned it. He got good hair, you know? Light-skinned, good hair, married.
Love you, bro.
Yeah. Let him go, ow! Let him do that. Let him do that. Ow! Yeah. They ain't gonna do it over Lee Williams. They ain't gonna do that. They ain't gonna do it over Mighty Clouds of Joy. Your daughter ain't gonna do that over Mighty Clouds of Joy. Stand up. Mighty Clouds of Joy. Oh, Mighty Clouds of Joy. Mighty Clouds of Joy, I'm 106 apart. No, okay. All right. What's burning in you, man? What's burning in you? What's burning in you?
As we talk about heroes, man, I can't help but to think about two young ladies, two teenagers, whose names are Cassie and Rachel. I don't know how many people here are familiar with the incident or the tragedy at Columbine High School in 1999. How many people here are familiar with that? Yeah, that was tragic. The long and short of it is two young men sort of went on a rampage and terrorized the Columbine High School. They built, pipe bombs and somehow got a hold of some shotguns. And one day went up to the school and blew up classrooms, shot and killed teachers and students, and then eventually killed themselves. But against the backdrop of that tragic story are two shining stars, two teenage girls whose names are Cassie and Rachel. Eric and Dylan are the two gentlemen. They approached Cassie and Rachel with the shotguns. Cassie and Rachel had a reputation for being passionate about the Lord Jesus Christ. So when they went on their rampage, they stuck the shotguns to their heads and said, do you still believe in God? Do you still believe in God? And both of them said yes. Needless to say, they died that day for their faith. The thing that concerns me, Kirk, is that we don't hear much talk about persecution anymore. We don't hear much talk about suffering anymore. The other day, I was in the bookstore, and I was grieved because I walked down 9 aisles, the front of the aisle and the back of the aisle, and in each aisle was the same thing. Books about our season and personal success. Now, is there anything wrong with that in and of itself? Absolutely not. But can we find anything that highlights the other side of the Christian faith, which is suffering for Christ's sake? The Bible says anybody who desires to live godly must suffer persecution. Yet, this is the thing that's low on the radar in the pulpit and in the pew.
My man, y'all.
So the thing that concerns me is in the body of Christ, we don't hear much talk about it. Yet, if you go to these other countries, Kurt, and they're having their body, their bodies are being mutilated. In Sudan, they mutilate you limb by limb until you pledge your allegiance to Jesus Christ. To Allah, sorry. They mutilate you limb by limb. I saw it myself. There's a documentary out. Until you pledge your allegiance to Allah. There's one author who predicts that 30 to 50 years from now, America will no longer be religiously tolerant. And he arrives at that conclusion because geographically, all the major cities are beginning to be dominated by Islam. And the question is, if that prediction is correct, will the people of God be prepared to stand up in the face of opposition? Well, these two young ladies were prepared. And I pray that our youth pastors are preparing our generation for the same thing. And that is to be like Cassie and Rachel and stand in the face of persecution and suffering for Christ's sake. This song is called The Legacy. And as we talk about heroes, I'd like to just highlight these two individuals and then challenge the people of God. Would you die for the Christ? That's the price of the call.
That's why I love him. Ladies and gentlemen, the truth.
Can you hear me out there? This is one you could just sit and listen.
Yes, it is.
You don't even have to clap. You could just listen. Who would have known that a couple of guys from Cullen behind would come from behind, put guns to the spine of some innocent people, the teachers, the students, feet of the teachers are screeching through rooms, and the mood is beset by the fear of the villains, the bombs and the threats of an Eric and Dylan, America's villains, generic you're feeling? It is not, it is the plot for a pair that is chilling in the glorious heavens, standing for Christ in a crisis. I know that it's rare what I'm feeling, excitement incited, declaring the pilgrims, faith in their fate, I'ma share with my children, Cassie and Rachel, the past of the patrons, passed through the ages, in Africa, Asia, the master that saved you, the laughter, the hatred, Jesus predicted that the masses would hate you, so don't think it's strange if a change might occur. If it does, are you ready and prepared for the curve and the turn for the worst? Would you fight? Would you fall? Would you die for the Christ? That's the price of the call.
Would you die for the Christ? That's the price of the call. Would you die for the Christ? That's the price of the call. Would you die for the Christ? That's the price of the call. Would you die for the Christ?
Listen, frustrated by the snares and the toils, parents annoy you. Truth of the matter is, we're arrogant, spoiled. America's soil is soil disorder. Pastors insist on declaring us royal.
And it's true.
True that we are, but we take it too far. To the point where we break and we take down a bar and forsake all the parts of the faith that are hard to embrace after all. We've outsmarted the martyrs, we raise up the charts. Trace it to the start. You will find out the way to escape from the dark. And your wake is the cough of the weight in the heart of the truth until everybody loves you. Jesus said, woe to you, all the new saints. Hold a view that you can go through the faith with nobody loathing you. That's a view that you only can hold when your home is the states. So don't think it's strange if a change might occur. If it does, are you ready and prepare for the curve and the turn for the worst? Would you fight? Would you fall? Would you die for the Christ? That's the price of the call.
Would you die for the Christ? That's the price of the call. Would you die for the Christ? That's the price of the call. Would you die for the Christ? That's the price of the call. Would you die for the Christ? That's the price of the call.
The bones that are picked are the bones that they're picked. That they comb through their homes with the stones and the sticks. Think of Rome as a stitch, so they rose up against them at home in their Rome, throwing stones at the Christians. Got a hold of them, gripped them, kicked them, scarred them, sawed them, they were thrown in a pit with the
told in a vermin and rolling eclipse. It's urgent, the scourges, the groans from the lips. The anger, the stranglings, the hangers, the danger. For all of the Christians that rolled in a click, ended up in the teeth of the beast that would feast on the saints that would preach. They were thrown off a cliff. This is not known to exist in a state or a place where the home is just bliss. This song is intense.
It's intense.
And it's truth, because I'm trying to convince you that no one's except, yet no one's equipped. Got our phones and our clips. Our focus is both on our loans and our trips. Our fitness, our business is thrown in a pitch. Would you fight, would you fall, would you ball up your fist? Would you fall to remorse to your grave, could you say your life is in Christ and the die is decay? Would you die in his name for the rise of the fame? Despising the shame, because you promised to reign. Calling his people to more than just personal success. God is calling his people to take up their cross and follow him, deny themselves. God is calling his people to be willing to die even socially. Maybe it won't be physical for you, but are you willing to die socially at least? For the rise of his fame.
God bless y'all. Yo. Yo, yo. Just before you leave. Yeah. No doubt. Watch it. Just before you leave. Because we need mamas and daddies to understand that hip hop and the music and even the funness of it when we were younger, that time is gone. That there was a time when you can listen to the Fat Boys, you can listen to Run DMC, or you can listen to what's my man from Philly? Will. Yeah, Will Smith. You could listen to stuff, you know, you could get your little, you know what I'm saying? All that. Those days when it comes to hip hop, it's like even when you listen to hip hop now, there's not even anything really even talented connecting to it. Let's not even, we can talk all day about the vulgarness. We can talk about all day how vulgar rappers are right now. You know, we can even talk all day about even the icons that are the women and the men and just, you know, just the sexiness and just the over-sexiness. And you got these young girls and young boys that everybody wants to look and be like these people. But we got to get the mamas and daddies and the pastors to understand. We got to get them to understand that if they come in with Tim's, if they come in with jeans, and if they come in and they not dressed like this, that behind the clothes, the child is redeemable. You know, and there's got to be a safety place for this Timberland wearing girl that when she comes into the church, there's got to be a safe place for her to fall. And then after she falls, we lovingly restore her. We lovingly bring her to the light. And you know what? She may never rock Mahalia Jackson. She may never transform into the Swanee Quintet. She may never get the Blind Boys record. She may never get it. And she shouldn't be condemned if she don't. Just quickly, man, because I'm looking at the audience, and you got some cute kids out here, man. You got some beautiful-looking girls, you know, some good-looking boys. You know, they're working on their swagger. They're trying to get their thing right. Just quickly, share with them that I know that the music is enjoyable. That the beats are banging and the little, you know, catchphrases are dope and hot that they're hearing. But can you just quickly, just share with them, just real briefly, that the poison up under it It's what's so destructive. Just in your own way.
I mean, you already said it, but
thank you.
But Kurt Franklin is absolutely right in that hip hop is even more than just lyrics these days. Like back in the day, there was a time where you even like. There was a generation coming up, my generation especially, like where we wanted to hear what the rapper was saying.
Word up.
Like Kurt was saying, it's empty today. Like, because nobody's even looking for any substance in hip hop anymore.
None.
Because we're in such a celebrity driven culture, it's more about who it is, not what they're saying. So they're more excited about these individuals that, you know, like the talentless individuals. Then they're more concerned about that than they are about what they're saying, And I just want to say this. This is the issue right here. The Bible says that David was a man after God's own heart, right?
Mm.
Now, that doesn't mean that God necessarily had something special for David, right? But what it means is that David was a man who pursued God's heart. He was after his heart, right? So it's like you say, yo, such and such is after me. That, you know, that can mean they're chasing me. So to be after God's heart was, David was basically a man pursuing God's heart, right? And what you find in David is he shares in the sentiments of God. So however God feels about something, that's how David feels about something, right? So you see David step to Goliath like, not who's this dude messing with my people? You see him stepping to Goliath and saying, who is this uncircumcised Philistine, right, taunting the armies of the Lord, right? So David's problem was the fact that this dude was messing with God's people, not his own, right? So you find David sharing in God's heart. And this is what I'm saying that to say this. God is looking for his people to share in his heart. So if God has a problem with D4L, we should have a problem with them as well. Because that's what it's going to boil down to at the end of the day.
Hold on.
Yeah.
That's a rap group.
Yeah. It's a hip-hop group. Paul Wall, I'm about to run a list of hip-hop groups. Paul Wall, Pow Wow, as y'all say out here, right? Paul Wall, there's a number of individuals that are leading hip-hop today that God has a problem with. And the Bible says this, who shall ascend to the holy hill of the Lord, right? Those with clean hands and a pure heart, right? It says those who honor those who fear the Lord and despise the wicked. So we have to share in the heart of God. This generation has to share in the heart of God and see the wicked the same way that he does. And if he's got a problem with them, we should have a problem with them as well.
That's good. That's why I love you, dog.
Yes, sir.
That's why I love it, dog.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Right before you go, the first album, there's a joint at the end that you spit.
Oh!
But no. And I do this because I know sometimes when that track came on, I saw some of the grandmamas. They were like, the beat was hitting the grandma was like, and she was trying to get into you. She was like, and she was really trying to enjoy your song, but that bass was killing. It was killing the heart thing.
Grandma,
yeah. It was killing her. She gave you the finger. She had to give the thing was killing. Give us something so they can see that there's really substance behind you. There's a joint that you do on the first album, and it's just an Acapulco joint, and you just rattle that boy. Give it to him. Give it to him. Give it to him.
Let's do it. This is about the resurrection of Jesus Christ. Paul said, if it wasn't for the resurrection of Jesus Christ, that the preaching of the gospel would be futile, that our faith would be in vain. So even beyond the crucifixion, the thing that we rejoice in is the resurrection. I'm homesick. This body's a tent. Heaven's where home is. If that's the case, then I guess it's safe to say that God's people are homeless. And just as sure as a fugitive runs, our monies are tied up in mutual funds. Cats be like, you got unusual ones. Oh, that's because the riches we got are stored up for after the funeral, son. Numeral one, Christ had to rip the veil.
Cause there was bad blood between us, like sickle cell anemia. The media, they keep feeding us lies, and immediately we eat it up like medium fries. Whoa. The heartbeat in his side longs for the day that Christ will return. Plus bring me to his side and clothe me in white. We'll be just like him, like Kobe and Mike. Me and my homies, my wife. Me and my homies like R. Swift, J. Solis, CM, Corey Precise. We going to glory, right? We headed to the new heaven, new earth, baby. I got proof. It's Jesus Christ's resurrection, and I'm not duped. This is objectivity. It's not my truth. I'm going to glory, y'all. How about you? You want me to do the second verse? I'm going to do the second verse. Let me do the second verse. My papa, watch this, y'all. My papa ain't no rolling stone. And when the angels rolled the stone away, you better know the Roman soldiers were blown away. We got a stowaway. Nah, Jesus Christ, he died, resurrected, he folded his clothes and stole away. Now that's incredible. He showed himself the credible witnesses that witnessed the death, but didn't expect them to come out of the grave just as the scriptures had said. And they thought the ladies were sick in the head when they came back reporting what they had seen with their eyes. The disciples were skeptical, so they sent Peter and John to verify what they told them. Jesus is risen. Meanwhile, the chief priests were bribing the soldiers. Obviously, with a valuable token, they told him to keep quiet and just to say that his body was stolen by the disciples at night while the soldiers were sleeping. But their story was leaking. He showed himself breathing, living and moving. Come on, come on, don't play with me. He showed himself breathing, living and moving. Showed him his feet and his nail-scarred hands, reiterated and told him his secret. He said, I'm the fulfillment of Moses' teachings. Cleopas' griefings turned into joy because they was hoping to see this Redeemer. Even Josephus wrote it as Jesus, the historical Christ. Even explorers alike, this irrefutable evidence in support of his life. Plus his dying, I am not lying. Tell your friend it's agnostic. God has got no skeletons in his closet. Nope. They can't find his bones, nowhere to be found. Not even his teeth, nowhere in the ground. Why? He's home wearing the crown. The disciples watched him ascend. Therefore, with Holy Spirit endowed, with the power to be witnesses. How many listeners know that when you die, you'll rise and be with the rest of us? We're not cocky, we're confident in the God who rescued us, plus resurrected his son from out of the sepulcher. If you've accepted these facts, then when this is over, you can email me and I'll be happy to rap. With you about matters concerning our faith, Jesus Christ's resurrection has determined our fate.
Yes, sir. The album is called The Faith. His name is The Truth. Go cop that, son. It's in stores. That's my man. One more time, get up on your sanctified feet and show some love for the truth. Ooh. Ooh. Now, Grandmama got that. Grandma, like I said, Grandmama say, oh, he all right now. He good. That boy good. He good. Woo! Wow. God will never leave himself without a witness. In any generation, he will have somebody that'll be a witness. Y'all good? Y'all good? Y'all not leaving, right? You here? You here? You good? You good? Don't be looking at your clock. Be looking at your watch. Hey, we're having a good time. Are you having a good time? Yeah. Now, we found out, again, just based on the emails, that y'all loved this dude last time. Yeah. This guy. I heard, you know, it's like churches are calling, trying to find out how to get him to do minister at the churches, you know, for couples ministries. And he's funny. He ain't got no sense. He really ain't got no sin. Loves the Lord, saved. I've been knowing him for now for 10 years, and y'all loved him so much that we had to call him back because he's so gifted. Many of y'all know him as Joe the Policeman on the What's Going Down episode of That's My Mama. Put your hands together for Jackson Heights home. Randy, no. Show some love for John Gray. Y'all loved him. Y'all loved him. So how you doing? How you doing?
Man, I'm doing great. I don't even know how to come behind the truth, man. He just stood there flat-footed. I saw Grant. You talking about Grant? She was about to worship. It's the first time I ever see somebody about to worship off of hip-hop. That's like a, you did something brand new tonight. When that's grandma, the grandma. She was like, yeah, yes, he's a sepulcher. Yes. He rose up. Oh!
That's what grandmama did. That's
grandma
what,
did that.
That's what grandmama.
But the hair was about to fall, so she put it back on.
She called it.
She called it. Thank you, Jesus.
You know, my grandmother, you know, now you're the comedian. I'm not a comedian, but when you said that, you know, it made me think of Gertrude.
Yes.
Because see, remember, when I was 4, Gertrude was 64.
Wow.
And so by the time I was like 10, we'd go to church, and you know, and Gertrude, and I never understood why my grandmama that was gray, why she would wear a jet black wig. Why did they wear?
That's a spirit of two-tone. That's a two-tone ministry.
And
touch somebody, say two-tone.
But
then, look at somebody.
But then, because she would need an edge up, the hair on her neck would be gray, but the wig
was jet black. Oh, it's a spirit of two-tone. How many people saw two-tone in your church on Sunday? Oh, it's nothing wrong with a little two-tone. She's old enough to have a two-tone ministry. She sings Negro spiritual. She's all right. She got two-tone. She use your clippers to edge up that neckline. Got gray fade and a jet black wig.
And what's the deal with that blue rinse that they would use? What? Y'all remember that blue rinse that grandmama wore?
What is it called?
Sulfate? Was it sulfate?
She said it. She know it. She use it. She was like, sulfate, get it right down there, CVS or Walgreens. Yes, she can. I see you.
So what's burning on your heart lately, man? So how you been? What you been doing? What you been doing?
Man, I've been traveling, doing singles conferences like you know, youth ministry and still doing the thing. And it's been crazy, man, since November 30th when we were here, man. God just kind of elevated stuff, and now it's like on another level.
So. Things haven't changed. Is everything still the same?
No, you know what?
Is everything still the same since November 30th?
Yeah, I can't give away my testimony. Is everything? Yes, I'm still the world's oldest virgin. Pray for me, amen. No. No, it's
not. That's a testimony.
That's right. And I really want to say this. I didn't get a chance to say this before. A lot of times, especially for young people, it's not popular for you to stand for holiness and still rock the, you know, the throwback and the cornrows. Let them know, just because I wear this, this does not define me. You still have a testimony. You can walk holy and rock contemporary. You don't have to wear white with white gloves and a white hat. Holiness is not a color. It's not a dress. It's not a hat. It is the posture of your heart. And that's what honors God. So
That's good. So, like in your travels, have you ran across anything funny lately?
See, as soon as you tell somebody you're a virgin, that just they sweep in. It's a spirit of sweeping. See there, they look just like, Jesus. There's an altar right here. But what I love is when people come, especially the women of God, see, because the women of God, I love the fact that they even bold enough to come and talk to me and tell me how my ministry or how my testimony affected them. Because some of the women of God, you know, single waiting on your promise, they're a little fake with it. They like, I don't need no man. Jesus is my boyfriend. He takes me to the mall and he hugs me at night and he feeds me crepes and we sit at the table and he feeds with me and he talks with me. Translation, I ain't got no man, don't nobody want me, I can't get a phone call. I don't need no man. Can I give you my number? Yes, what is it? I got it. I just remember it. I remember it.
What else you been running into, Pointy? What else been going on?
I think for me, the best thing is seeing people's seasons change because they think because the weather is nice, they still, you know, they're not sure what to wear. I saw a lady with a short sleeve turtleneck. It's like, okay, you don't know if you want to be hot or cold. What are you doing? Who would make a short sleeve turtleneck in the first place? And why would you buy it and still wear gloves? What's wrong? What's wrong with you? And then I see the men at church rocking these muscle shirts. The operative word is muscle. If you don't have the muscles, brother, please don't wear the shirt. The only person that can wear the muscle shirts is Eddie Long. He the only one. Eddie Long got the Jerry curl. I love Bishop. He be like, watch this.
We love you, Bishop Long. Bishop Long, we love you.
Oh, he's a man of God. I'm saying he the only one that can do it because he makes it look good and he's anointed. But everybody trying to follow his footsteps, they can't do it because they got the ministry right here. You can't do that. You got the ministry right here. You can't do that.
What else?
Now, I'm amazed, really, honestly, at when you talk about this new generation, of which you are one of the forerunners. And, you know, he's been so faithful to pouring everybody else and give everybody else big props. Why don't you give it up for the man of God real quick for what he's done? Yeah. Every now and then, it's all right to throw it back, man. Yeah, that's all right. That's right. Give it up. You know, you talk about, I mean, with all of the influence God has given you, you still talking about living holy. You still talking to a generation about walking upright. And like the truth said, there's not enough people talking about the sacrifice and what it means. You're not going to be popular, young people. You're not going to be popular at your school when you tell them, I'm not smoking trees. I'm blessing God. I'm not going to that party. I'm blessing God. It's not going to be popular. The Bible says you're going to be hated by all men for his sake. Jesus said that out of his own mouth. So don't expect for popularity, but expect for prominence. Because popularity will fade and prominence will last because you'll have substance to give to people. And that's what counts.
That's good. So you got anything closing? I mean, before you, you got anything you want to do? You got a song, a selection, anything you want to do?
A song or a selection?
Don't try to come for me now.
No, I'm not that messy. You pretty. You look wonderful tonight. You look... I quit.
You got some short jokes?
No, I ain't got no short jokes. I'm just saying, I just love you because you so anointed and you know, I'm big and he little. We look like the number 10 standing next to each other. He's skinny, I'm big, and you know, it's cool. But I love him. You know, honestly though, Kirk, what I do wanna...
Go and get the laugh out.
Y'all know y'all thought it too, because when he sing, and you know, he's not Wilt Chamberlain, he ain't the tallest man in the world. You just be like, oh, you bless me. Kirk, I love you, hero. You my little hero. Yes, you are. You Kirk Franklin, I love you. What's your name, girl? You all right? You know, I'm single. I don't mind. Look at our brown skin. Hold on, this lady in the green looking like Apple Now Laters. Come sit down. Sit down. Service ain't over. Sit down. Put the Baptist church finger up. What you waving at? This ain't Price is Right. I ain't got nothing. Come on down.
Do you have a song, anything you want to do before it's time for you to go, before they don't invite me no more?
They're going to invite you. You're the man of God. You know what? When Truth was talking about, when Truth was talking about the generation.
Hold on, let him get it out.
Go on, get the laugh out. He is crazy. No, you crazy. You got a gold tooth next to a silver tooth. Pick one color. I quit.
What's your song? Sing your song.
You know what?
Sing your song. Do something.
You know what I found out, honestly? Past all of the songs, and you let me have a moment to sing a song that was on my album that's out. There's, when you grow up, when you in church and you little, you sing songs that the deacons sing, and you don't know why they're singing it, but when you get older, you realize that there's power in those songs. Like, everybody's been singing old songs. All these contemporary artists, they found something to pull on. See, that's cross-generational. Even though we're moving at the forefront, we still don't forget our roots. So, song I sing when I really need to get through is, what a friend we have in Jesus. And all our sins and griefs to bear. And what a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. And oh, what peace we often forfeit. And oh, what needless pain we bear. Carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, 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 take everything to God in prayer.
Ladies and gentlemen, show some love for my homeboy, John Gray. You having a good time? You having a good time? Woo. My little hero. My little hero. That was so good. Y'all come on, y'all come on, y'all come on, y'all come on, y'all come on. We're gonna keep it going, we're gonna keep it going. Keep it going. Somebody tell my singers to get ready for me, please. So can y'all come back and do me one more song? Can you come back and give me one more song? Listen, whatever y'all want to do, you know, for the young kids, whatever. One more time, we're going out on tour. I'm excited about that. We're going
to pray for John Gray. I want somebody to lay hands.
I personally love
him. He is crazy. He is crazy. He is crazy. You got a song for me?
Yeah, we got a song for you. We need some participation for this.
Yeah. Will y'all help us out? Y'all be the Mary Mary Mass Choir for us.
But you can't do it if you don't follow the director. If I go like this, you got to follow me, you know.
All right, let's get it started. Y'all gonna help us? Y'all remember, thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah.
Oh, oh. Tragedies are commonplace. All kinds of diseases, people are slipping away. Economy's down, people don't get enough pay. But as for me, yeah, all I can say is thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Yeah. Now folks without homes are in the street, and the drug habits some say they just can't beat. Muggers and robbers, no place seems to be safe, but you've been my protection every step of the way. And I wanna say thank you, Lord, for all you've done for me. Without a friend, or just another number, with a track.
the Hero Tour, 2006. Mary, Mary. Mary, Mary, y'all. Where's my Kennedy? Where's my Kennedy? Let me see my Kennedy. Come here, come here, come here, come here. I just want everybody to see my Kennedy. Come here. Come here. Come here. Everybody say hi to my 8-year-old. This is Kennedy. I want you to know that I am so proud of you. You're doing such a good job. I'm very proud of you, how you're doing in school and everything. I'm just want you to know that Daddy is very, very, very proud of you. All right? Show some love for these incredible people right here. Jana, Ashley, Erica, Charmaine, Faith, Anaysha. Anaysha, baby girl Nikki, Eric, and Jason. Show some love for these great singers. So can we do a song? This is my wife's favorite song. Play it. Let's go. It's off the new album. The Hero album. Imagine Me. Everybody bob your head with me. In the balcony, how y'all doing? This is for all my people up there. Dedicated to all.
struggle with acceptance, insecurities, and even low self-esteem. You never felt beautiful enough. You never felt good enough. But imagine God whispering in your ear, letting you know that everything that has ever happened to you is now.
Sing that again. Come on.
Oh, na, 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 na.
Oh, na, 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 na.
Snap with it.
Oh, na, 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 na. Oh, na, 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 na.
Sing it, young people. Come on.
Oh, na, 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 na.
Everything that happened.
Oh, na, 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 na.
Every hurt.
Oh, na, 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 na.
Every problem.
Oh, na, 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 na.
When you look in the mirror. You were made in God's image.
Oh, na, 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 na.
Don't let no boy tell you different.
Oh, na, na, na.
Fellas, don't let no girl tell you different.
Na, 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 na.
You're created in God's beauty.
Oh, na, na, na.
He made you beautiful.
Oh, na, 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 na.
Make him know your interior.
Oh, na, na, na,
before he falls in love with the exterior.
Oh, na, 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 na.
Let him see the Jesus in you.
Oh, na, na, na.
Because it's beautiful.
Oh, na, na.
Last time.
Oh, na, 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 na. Oh, na, 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 na.
Next song. Next song. How many of you know Jesus is the hero? If you know that, if you know he's a hero, like you're crazy, holler, make noise, young people, right now! You gonna sing it? You know, how many of you know it? How many of you know it? You know it? You know it? If you know it, watch this, watch it.
Even though we deny, you're the only sacrifice that I love.
Before we leave here, I just want to make sure that every young person in here, since we've been talking about you, and we've been talking about the heroes, the people that give and give, and nobody ever tells you thank you, nobody ever celebrates you, I don't want you to get discouraged in your well-doing. Do you hear me, church? Those of you that have been giving and giving and giving and they can't even tell you thank you, they never let you know that they appreciate you. Don't get discouraged in your well-doing. Young man, young woman, you're staying faithful to God, you're trying to live a life at school, and it seems like it's you against the world. I want you to stay faithful. I want you to stay faithful. And I know that it's easier said than done when the culture's pulling at you. But I want you to know that someday the same people that are laughing now, they're going to be looking at your life when God walks you into a place of blessing. And when I say blessing, I'm not talking about the whip. I'm talking about you be 30 and still in your right mind. You be 35 and not having 2 and 3 babies on one hip. Working on your third marriage. Because you sowed seeds when it wasn't popular to sow seeds. You were talking about Jesus when the culture was talking about banging in their white tee. And now their white tees are now hanging down to Negroes' ankles. And now you just walking around owning the dealership and owning the companies and now making and turning a profit for the kingdom because you were faithful when everybody else was living for the world. I want every young man and young woman in here to know that God is writing down your commitment. He's writing down your faithfulness. And to all you single mothers, don't give up on us boys. All of the single mothers, don't give up on the boys. You're raising them. I want you to know that God will give you the power to be mama and daddy. And I want you to know that just like God turned my life around, God will do the same thing for that boy if you will walk up right before him. You don't have to sacrifice just to have a man in the house to give him an image of a man. God will be the image of a man that he needs. Can I get a witness in here right now? God will not bring you into a relationship with him just to watch you die. God will not allow you to suffer so long that it breaks your faith in him. God would be cruel if he made the world blazing and exciting and made your life look so dead and dumb. He will give you joy right where you stand, and he has to do it because his name is faithful. So, Father, before we go and do this last song, I just want to encourage everybody, to everybody who doesn't get the applause and everybody who doesn't get the hand clap and the pat on the back. I want everybody to know that standing here that may get discouraged and feeling like that my sacrifice is in vain. Father, give them just a glimpse of eternity. Father, take the scales off their eyes and they can do like you want us to do. Like Paul said in Colossians, we want to set our hearts and our mind on things above, not on earthly things, for we died and our life is now hidden with you. And all these tangible things will soon pass away. But great is our reward in eternity. Let us don't get discouraged and hanging in there and doing what we know makes you smile. That puts a smile upon your face. So right now, every young man and young woman that's watching and listening right now, let them make you first. Let them make you the top priority. In the name of Jesus, amen. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. Did you have a good time? Were you blessed? And how many of y'all young soldiers are really going to take something that you heard tonight? And when you get to, well, hold on. And when, well, hold on. And when you get to the classroom tomorrow. When we see you at the Parks Mall tomorrow. When we see you at Redbud. When we see you out in the streets, please don't let this be a night of entertainment. Let there be an investment and a deposit. And I want you to know that when we see you, we're proud of you and we believe in you. And we're not going to take the Bible and beat you upside the head. We want to encourage you to be the young, beautiful men and women that we know that you really are. So please, tomorrow, take some of this and make a deposit in somebody else's life. You good? Show some love for Myron Butler and Levi. Show some love for the truth. Show some love for John Gray. Show some love for my band and singers. Show some love for my family. We're going to do the selection. God bless y'all. Play the track. Let's have a Holy Ghost party. Let's go. Oh! Oh! Say, ooh, ooh, ooh. Say, ooh.
How y'all doing up here? Come on, come on. Say yeah, yeah. And the Holy Ghost party say yeah,
oh, yeah.
And clap your hands twice like that. Break
y'all. Thank y'all. We're married now. Come on, come on, Levi. Come on, Levi. Come on, Levi. Come on, come on.
Come on, Byron.
Come on, Levi. Then we got 2 minutes. So I gotta stretch out 2 minutes. Come here, Byron. Now, Byron, show us what Levi do. When it get real good, when it get real good to Levi, what they do, Byron, what they do. What y'all do?
I know there's a little mother. TBN has a worldwide
in
ministry.
This audience,
we need your love gifts, large or small, to help keep the gospel of Jesus Christ going around the world. So write today. Praise the Lord, P.O. Box A, Santa Ana, California, 92711. In Canada, TBN, P.O. Box 768, Station B, Ottawa, Ontario, A1P 5P8. If you haven't asked Christ into your life, call a prayer partner now and pray to receive Jesus as Savior and Lord. Now, until next time, remember to praise the Lord.
This program has been brought to you through the prayers and contributions of our faithful partners throughout North America and the world. This program has been brought to you through the prayers and contributions of our faithful partners throughout North America and the world.